Oh boy, do we have a juicy video for you today. This video is packed to the brim with info, so let's not dilly-dally around too much and let's just get started. Now, about a week ago, I put out a survey and I asked you your top two questions when it comes to character animation. The response to that survey, by the way, was overwhelming. Your answers were very insightful. I sat there all day eagerly watching as your answers came in, and up until this point, I've read every single one of your answers. So if you took the time to take that survey, a big thank you from me. Mwah. In a couple of weeks, by the way, we'll be sharing more information about how we plan to make character rigging and animation in After Effects easier, less painful, and more efficient. So keep an eye out for our updates and subscribe if you haven't already. But in the meantime, let's dive into Limber. And let's get started with tip number one, faux 3D limbs. A couple of months ago, I released a video on this channel about how to add perspective to Limber Lite. Limber Lite is the free version of Limber. And that video involved using Duik in combination with Limber Lite, and it involved a lot of setup. But did you know that if you own the full version of Limber, there is a pre-built limb that does the exact same thing? Now you might be scratching your head thinking you got ripped off because the last time you checked Limber, there was only these four types of limbs. Ah. But when you downloaded Limber, it also included a little project file, a project file full of surprises. Hopefully you've stored this file somewhere nice and cozy on your hard drive. And to use this file, you just tell Limber where you stored it, and then you'll never have to navigate to that folder again. To import the file, you just click this button with two clicks, one, two, boom. Look at all these limbs. Most of these limbs are unique, by the way, and they have unique controls and capabilities. The limb I want to show you is this one, the faux 3D limb. This limb is set up so that you can use the color split properties in the settings and the rounding to create the same faux 3D perspective I demonstrated in my Limber Lite video, but this time with way less effort. Tip number two, you can combine presets. As you look at these presets, do you notice anything strange? Did you notice that they're all named left leg? Even the ones called arms are named left leg. Even this one with the hand. I don't know, maybe this preset is there in case you need to make a guy with hands for feet. Well, actually, this is intentional so that you can combine different assets from different presets together. Now, please forgive the rudimentary nature of this rig. Not my best work. This was the last rig I built for this video, and I was running out of time, and I just needed to make something to demonstrate that you can combine different presets and different assets from presets. So I know it's not pretty. Please forgive me. For the arms, I combine assets from three different presets. I use the muscles for the base. Then I copied and pasted the sleeve from this t-shirt preset, and then I copied this foot to use as the hand, feet for hands. And boom, brand new monstrosity, never before seen. Now, when you are copying assets from one preset to another, instead of using Limber's copy and paste buttons, you're gonna have to do it the way the pioneers did it, the old fashioned way with Control C and Control V. A lot of these presets have additional controls on the limb layer itself that control different attributes of that particular preset. For example, this muscle preset has controls for the muscle size. I like to copy these presets over first, these settings, and then go back and copy the relevant shape groups in the content section of the limb layer itself. If you paste the shape group first without the controls, you might get confused when you don't see anything happen. That's why I like to copy the controls first. So there you go. You can go explore the presets and try to combine different things and see what you get. I don't know, you can kind of feel like Dr. Frankenstein a little bit. Now this is where things are gonna start to get juicy. But first, I want to shout out today's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes in design, business, technology, and more. With a Skillshare membership, you'll have access to high quality video classes taught by industry experts, as well as a supportive community of learners to help you along the way. Plus, new classes are added all the time, so there's always something new to learn. I've recently just finished this class from DKNG Studios on mastering Illustrator. This class has been a killer resource in helping me optimize my workflow and save me time in Illustrator, because as a motion designer, I spend a surprising amount of time in Illustrator. And that class was so good, I can't wait to get into their other Illustrator classes. If you want to try out Skillshare yourself, I have a link for 1 month free trial of Skillshare down in the description. And if you do take advantage of that offer, I highly recommend you go check out this class, Mastering Illustrator by DKNG Studios. It's killer. Okay, with that said, let's get back on track. Okay, now on to trick number three, adding details. The most straightforward way to add details to your limbs is just by drawing them on a separate layer and then pick whipping them to your controllers. If this is something you know you want to do, the first thing you need to change is your rotate start setting, which either is the hip or shoulder, depending on the kind of limb you're working with, and set that rotate start to 100%. That way, anything you pick whip to that controller will stick to the upper part of your limb because it will rotate with the limb. For the lower part though, we won't be using the end controller, which is either the wrist or the ankle, but instead we'll create a new joint for the middle with this little button over here, add joint. Then on this new controller, we will set it to rotate with the lower part of the limb. Now we can pick whip all of our detail layers to this new joint in the middle and they will stick to the lower part of our limb. Now you might ask, why can't we just set the rotate end 100% and pick whip our detail layers to that end controller? Well, most likely you'll need to animate the rotation of that controller, whether it's the wrist or the ankle. And when you do, all the details that are pick whipped to it will rotate with it and won't stick to the limb itself. There are some drawbacks to adding details this way. One, those details won't scale with your limb. So if you need to stretch it, they won't scale. Now, that might not be a big deal to you because you're not animating Elastigirl and you don't need them to stretch, okay. But they also won't adjust when you shorten the length of the segment. That's where Rig and Pose comes in. Here in Illustrator, you can see how I've broken my character in preparation for Rig and Pose. First, I've separated the leg from the illustration and then I've straightened it out. Whenever you're setting up a limb, it's always easiest to set everything up in a straight line down. And the reason is it's really a lot easier to make sure that each section, the upper art layer and the lower art layer, are meeting at the center of each joint. When you try to do it at an angle, it's a little difficult. And having them go through the middle of each joint is crucial if you want your joints to bend seamlessly. To the right, I've separated out the different components just to show you how the limb is kind of broken up into its different layers. Back in After Effects, I'll select the joints first, starting with the top, then I'll select the upper art layer and the lower art layer. With everything selected, I'll go over to my limb type and choose three circles. Whenever you use Rig and Pose like this, it will use whatever type of limb you have set in this drop-down menu as the base of the limb. In this case, I could use a taper limb and probably be just fine, but the use of three circle limbs will be crucial in our next tip. And it will work a little bit faster without having to render the in-between. Now let's go ahead and open the Rig and Pose. Since I select the layers in the correct order, they're all loaded in the correct slots. If they are not, this is your chance to correct any mismatches. Then to combine everything, I just click OK. Limber will do its magic. The advantage of a Rig and Pose is now I can stretch my limb and the details will stretch with it, or I can shorten the length of either segment and the details will move and just kind of stretch with that, giving me just a little bit more flexibility in the kind of motion I can get out of this. Now, a word of caution, when you design details for your character, steer clear of the joints. The joints make everything a little bit more tricky. Let's move on to tip number four. Working with outlines, which is also a very common question I get. So you're working on an explainer style video and the designer sends you over a character that looks like this, riddled with outlines. Let me show you how I approach this rig by recreating the arm. First, instead of trying to separate the arm from the illustration, I just remade the arm from scratch. I created the joints first and then moved on to the bicep and forearm. Now, when I created my joints, just like with the last rig, I'm going to place them in a vertical line because that's the easiest way to make sure everything lines up. Now, the key to creating limbs with outlines is to create open-ended shapes on each side that joins up with the joint. Problem is that shapes can only have one open section between two points. Luckily, with this upper portion of the arm, I was able to create two rectangles with open ends on either end of the bicep, because I have this little detail in the sleeve right here that I can use to hide where those two rectangles meet up. thus creating a seamless shape with any open ends on either side. Now, a note on adapting illustrations. Your character rigs do not have to follow your illustrations to the T 100% of the time. It's up to your discretion as the rigger to make adjustments to the illustration in order to make a functioning rig. The designer who designed this probably doesn't know anything about character rigging and doesn't know how things fit together, evidenced by this sleeve detail right here being right smack dab in the middle of the arm where the elbow is. And as we mentioned in the last tip, you should avoid placing any kind of details on the joints. So I just slide this little detail up the bicep a little bit and then bada bing, bada boom, we're good. This little adjustment makes the rig look better when the arm is bending, and it doesn't really change anything important about the character. Now, when it comes to the forearm, I needed to create a rectangle that had two open sides on the elbow and the wrist. To do this, I created a rectangle without a stroke, and then I manually drew in the strokes on either side to match up. It's really not anything special. It's pretty straightforward. Now I'll just group those together, and then I'll bring those as one layer into After Effects. Then, just like with the last limb, once we're in After Effects, we've got all our shapes in, I'll use the Rig and Pose to rig everything up. However, Rig and Pose does not copy the stroke from your joints, so you'll have to go in after you've done everything and add those strokes manually. To do this, open the upper group and turn off the visibility of C2 group. We don't need this unless we want the bicep to be underneath the forearm. Then we'll go to the lower group and we'll add our stroke to the C2 and C3 groups. C2 and C3 are the circles that represent your elbow and your wrist, respectively. You can add a stroke to your shoulder, but in the case of this particular rig, I decided just to leave this shoulder joint open and without a stroke. Now that's how you make a seamless outlined limb. But with outlines, it isn't just the limbs that are tricky, it's joining the limbs to the rest of the character that is tricky. For the hips, you can use an open-ended shape and line your controllers up with the bottom edge and the side edge of that shape. It's really that simple. For the torso, however, if your character is straight on, you'll need to have open sections on either side where the shoulders will fit in. To create this, you can use the same method we use for the forearm by just drawing the shape of your torso without outlines and then drawing the outlines on separately and leaving gaps where the shoulders are going to go. Now, if your character's at a 3/4 perspective, you don't really have too much to worry about the arm behind the body, but the arm in front of the body can be a little bit tricky. But we're running out of time, so that will have to be revisited in another video. Okay. On to our last trick, number 5, pose the rig. Now, I know it's called rig and pose, but this technique I'm calling pose to rig because oftentimes you're given an illustration where the character is already set up in a pose, which sometimes can be a little irritating, but sometimes it's kind of nice because figuring out that pose can be kind of the hardest part. I'm gonna show you how we can completely retrofit this entire illustration all inside of After Effects using Limber. So, first the arms. I'll take my pen tool and I'll draw 3 points to match the joints of the arm. Then I'll go in and match the taper of this stroke to the width of the arm and I'll turn off the fill. New shape layer selected, I'll go and click Path to Bone. And now that stroke I just drew has turned into a working, bendable arm. Now I can go in and I can duplicate this original stroke and turn it yellow and trim paths it so that it matches this little yellow line, and I can add all the other details. Now for the leg, it seems a little more intimidating because it's got these curves and it seems a little more detailed, but it's really not that complicated. We can do it pretty quickly. So to do the legs, I'm going to again select the 3 circles limb and create a new limb. Then I'm going to match up the hip and ankle controllers to the illustration. And then I'm gonna adjust the length of the upper and lower segments until the knee is right where I want it. This might take a little time to get it just right. Then I'll adjust the width of each joint to match the illustration. Okay, so now I don't really wanna try and trace these middle sections because it's kind of difficult to make sure that you're connecting the shapes and that you're going through directly through the middle of each joint, which you need to do if you want your seams to be flawless. Remember, I mentioned earlier that it is always easiest to illustrate your limbs when they are straight. So to do this, I'll open the FK section in the settings of my ankle and turn the FK all the way up to 100%. This will straighten out the limb, making it much easier for me to make sure my connections are going right through the middle of my joints. Now, I'm lucky with this illustration because both the upper and lower parts of the limb are made up of two shapes, so it's easy for me to create shapes that have open ends on the top and bottom for each section. Okay, so to review, I have my limb layer and I have my two art layers, and once again, we'll use rig and pose. This time I'll just select my limb layer and the upper art layer and the lower art layer, which will load everything into the rig and pose correctly. Then I'll hit okay, limber will do its thing, and then boom. I now have a working bendy limb that looks nearly identical to the illustration. And when I bend the limb, all my lines are lined up perfectly, seamlessly.
And because this character is outlined, I will have to go in and add a stroke to the C2 group so that the knee is outlined.
So there you go, 5 tricks for using Limber. I'm curious, did you learn something new or am I just preaching to the choir? Did you learn anything that solves a problem or a hurdle that you've been encountering lately? Or did I miss anything? And most importantly, have I opened your eyes to what's possible to do with Limber? Let me know your answers and any questions you might have in the comments section below. Character animation, I think, is a lot of fun, especially if you do it right. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Like I said in the beginning of this video, we have something special coming up in January, which we'll be announcing soon. So make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out. Next week, we're going to go over some of the tools that I use that make the animation process easier and faster. So make sure you hit that bell icon so that you're notified when that comes out. If this video was helpful, I'd really appreciate a like on the video. That really helps me out. And with that, we'll see you guys in next week's video.